One of the devices that virtually everyone has is an optical disc drive, a CD or a DVD. These can be a computer DVD drive, a portable CD player, a car stereo system with disc playback, or a sound system. The most frustrating thing about these drives is that they fail quite often. Certainly, one can have their failed DVD drive repaired, but the cost of such repair is nearly equal to that of the device itself, so it's not always economically sound. Let us try and understand the internal design, and perhaps this information helps you perform repairs or simply proves useful. So the design of CD, DVD and BD drives is fundamentally the same. The difference is only in the laser beam itself, its wavelength and focus and precision. The principle of operation is similar to record players, where a stylus moving along the surface gets into pits and causes the membrane to vibrate. The only difference being that a laser beam is used here, which hits micropits, the informational layer, surface, reflects from them and goes to the photosensor, triggering either a logic 0 or 1 at its output, dependent on the pulse duration. Let us dismantle our drive and have a look at its internal design. We can see a tray on which the disc is placed. It is set in motion by a rack and gear drive from a standard commutator motor. Here we can see the spindle on which discs sit. It is covered with a friction pad on top, which makes sure the disc is not slewing at acceleration or slowdown. Position system is comprised of guide rods along which the laser head is moving. This laser head's design deserves more detailed attention. It is essentially as a laser diode whose emission is focused by a lens, suspended on small springy wires in the magnetic field of special coils, varying voltage applied to those coils. Enables control over focus and precision, and equivalently over the distance from the disc to ensure best data reading accuracy. Let's connect it and see it in action. This strange creaking sound is heard exactly because of disc slewing on the spindle surface, since a hold down part is needed on top to prevent the disc from coming off and slewing. Among major malfunctions, one can note the following. Clogging of the laser head position system and tray drive mechanism. Contamination of the spindle with some oily liquids and clogging of the laser head itself. Thus, all these malfunctions can be easily eliminated just by cleaning the drive. Of course, the lens may have lost alignment as a result of a fall or a shock, in which case one can try and realign it manually with pincers. Certainly, no one can guarantee drive's impeccable operation after this, but it should be well sufficient for a few more discs. The electronic component is represented with circuits and as if no interest to us, since it is rather difficult to comprehend without adequate knowledge. Thus, we have become familiar with the internal design of an optical disc drive.